Hey!
What?
You are crazy. Well, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, everybody. We are on our way to take you where?
To the YMCA daycare.
YMCA. Yes, you are.
And also at the YMCA, I'm going swimming.
Do y'all swim inside or outside?
Depends on the weather. If it's not going to rain at the lunch once it's after 11 o'clock, then it's going to be outside.
Anyway, that's what we're doing today. He's on his way to go to the Y. I am on my way to go to work. It's Monday. Monday fun day. Yeah, right. Monday, the day to start everything back over. But it's okay because we're feeling good. We're feeling good. Right?
Yeah, Monday is the day of torture.
No, it's not. Why is Monday a torture day?
It starts on the beginning of the week.
So why is that torture?
Because I don't want to go. I want to stay in bed all day.
You're one of those kids.
Yeah, I want to stay in bed, go downstairs, watch TV, go outside.
You just did that, though, all weekend.
I didn't go outside all weekend.
You went yesterday.
And also, I didn't play all day.
Did you play ball yesterday?
Huh? Yeah, that was only one day the whole week.
I don't know if any of you guys ever experienced it, but it is not cool to bully. And bullying is just awful. I do not accept it. I do not like it, whether it's being done to my child or whether it's being done to someone else's child. Bullying is not cool.
It's wrong.
It's very wrong. And no one should do it. And it's, you know, I don't know how bullying even starts and why someone wants to be so mean to somebody.
It might be because other people are being mean to him.
It could be, but you know, it shouldn't be done, period. And thankfully, Zaven knows how to remove himself from a situation before it escalates, and I'm very thankful for that he doesn't retaliate the way that some people may do. And I think that's what makes the person even matter, is because you're not retaliating. But the point of the matter still is, bullying is not right. And bullying starts at every age, to be honest. But I also feel like when something has been said about it, instead of making your child be removed from the situation, like the person that's doing the bullying, I really feel like sit down and talk to your kid and don't just try to cover it up or make it better by saying, well, you just can't play with them, you know, and I think that's wrong. I truly feel like we should make our kids protect themselves, because we cannot be around them all the time. That's the sad part. We cannot be around them constantly. So if something was to happen and in their defense, if someone did something to them, then yes, I truly feel like we should be able to let them know that you have my permission to protect yourself and do whatever it takes to make sure that you know that you are not harmed. But also be smart about it too. If you can prevent it, then go and tell an adult, if you have an adult around you, that this is what is happening to you. So I know that's how it was when I was brought up. I had to protect myself. I can't remember too much of having a bully. I remember being in school and having kids that didn't like me for whatever reason, but nobody bullied me. But bullying is not cool. Not cool. Not cool. Not cool bullying, right? No, yeah. Bullying. Not cool. It's Monday morning and I'm feeling great. It's going to be a good day today. I'm going to declare that. You should too. I hope everybody has an awesome day. I hope you woke up on the right side of the bed and you make this day full of whatever you can possibly make it. But remember to make it good. I know today is going to be busy at work. We had one doctor that was on vacation and she will be back today. My manager also was on vacation. She will be back today. The schedule is going to be full because I saw that Friday. We have a birthday today to celebrate at work and we have a staff meeting. So what does all of that entail? Food is going to be at work, okay? I don't know about you guys, but if any of you all work at an office or you work at any environment where you celebrate everything, I mean everything, so there's constantly food. Y'all, where I work, if you trying to be on somebody's diet, the devil will come in and sit on your desk. I'm just telling you. The devil will sit on your desk and he will make you go over there to that counter or up them stairs or around that corner and eat you a biscuit. I am so serious. When you work where I work, you have to have willpower. You have to have willpower simply because we got food all the time. We have reps that brings us food. We have birthdays that we celebrate through food. We have holidays that we celebrate through food. Hell, we celebrate through food. I mean, it's just we find comfort in food. I think the average human being does find comfort in food. I believe that's why there's so many obese people. But hey, it is what it is. My actual diet that I am supposed to start, which I am starting with a coworker at work, I am trying something else, something new, to kind of help me stay, or hopefully to help me stay on that right path, and see if I can't create and keep a better me instead of starting, stopping. Because my stomach does not hold a whole lot of food, still doesn't mean that I can't gain weight. It does not mean that, because if you put the wrong thing in your mouth, guess what? You're still gonna either stay the same or increase. And that's where I am. I know that food is a whole mind game. I understand that. But my mind just keeps telling me yes, and it don't say no. R. Kelly lied. My mind is telling me yes. No? Okay. My mind will tell me yes when my stomach will say no. My mind tells my stomach, you can take this last piece. You can do this. Look, slide that over there on the corner and put this piece right there. I'm telling you it'll fit. Knowing damn well that piece of food is not going to fit in your belly anymore. It's a mind of a matter, y'all, on everything that you do. And it's all up here. You have to be able to control this to be able to control everything else. And I'm weak. I will let you guys know more about it when I actually get more into it. First 4 days are supposed to be your crucial days, okay? And the reason why is because you are trying to make sure you spill all of the ketones out of your system. That's it. First 4 days. Nothing else. And water. Meat, egg, cheese, water. That's it. So I'm a little nervous about it, and I'm only nervous because it's in my mind right now, and I'm thinking, what if I can't, what am I gonna do without my candy, what am I gonna do without this, so it's all in my mind right now, but I know I can do it, I'm telling you I can do it, I say I can do it, I know it's going to happen. Nobody's going to defeat me. I'm going to make it happen right now, tomorrow, for the rest of my life, right? Yeah. I'm going to keep telling myself that over and over. So, anyway, today, I'm going to live it up like it ain't no tomorrow. I'm going to live it up. I'm going to try to fit everything in that little belly that I can possibly fit because I can't get it no more. I'm going to live it up today. So, I'm going to go to work, and we're going to be happy because we're going to eat, and then we're going to have our staff meeting, and then we're going to go home, and then everything else is going to start. So, anyway, that's going to be the bulk of my day or my morning. No, actually my day because I don't get off the 5. I will chit-chat with you guys later, and have a good day, have a good night, have a good evening, wherever you are. Make the best out of what it is. Love you guys. See you in a little bit to let you know what all I ate today, right? Because I know you're looking forward to it. Bye. Good morning, boos. How are you doing? It's a new day. It is Tuesday this morning. And it's still a good day. So that's awesome. Hope everybody out there is doing well. I didn't get to get Zaven in the seat with me this morning. He's at camp already. But he's having a good day. They did not go anywhere today. I think they're just chilling inside of the camp. But I am on my way to work, and it was something I was going to tell you guys. Oh, it is the first day of the diet. So I'm a little nervous because I've had to give up all of my good goods, which is my candy and my breads. Now, I know personally that I could probably do without the bread. The bread is not going to kill me as bad as the candy would. And I am that particular type of person who has to have like a peppermint or a Jolly Rancher, a Lifesaver, Now Later, Airhead. That's my candy that I go to. I'm not like your chocolate girl. I have to have me some chocolate or something like that. No, I don't have to do that. But those candies that I did say, I need those in my life every day. So that's going to be hard. But I tried to help myself yesterday. So at the close of business yesterday, I went through and I took all of the candy and stuff that I had in my desk. I had a bag full of candy that I got for my birthday, and I made up little bags for the kids when they come in to get their vaccinations, and I pretty much just distributed that candy through those bags to give to the kids, so I don't have it in my drawer anymore. All the other candies, the M&Ms, the crackers, the granola, the fruit, that's another thing, you guys. You can have fruit, but not on the first 4 days. You can start incorporating fruit back into your diet after you've pretty much like hit your goal. I am a fruit girl too. That's probably one of the first things that I go to when I am hungry. I love watermelon. I love peaches. I love basically any type of fruit. And to not be able to have it, especially at its ripest season, that's going to be a bummer. But you can, like I said, after you've pretty much got good in the diet, you can start putting stuff back in. So I am a little nervous, but excited at the same time. I'm nervous because I'm scared that I'm going to start craving things that I do like. I am excited because I know that I can do this. It's just about sticking to it and making this your life goal decision and learning how to treat your body, to give your body what your body needs, and to stick with it, y'all. That's pretty much what it is. It's a regimen, learning how to stick with it. So I'm excited. I'm pumped up about it. I know I can do it. I'm gonna tell myself this every day. I'm gonna tell myself this all day today, and hopefully that it doesn't have me feeling like some of the people said that it does, which is grumpy because you're hungry, woozy because you feel like you haven't had a lot to eat, and just tired like. So I'm hoping that it does not do that for me, seeming that I got a little up on the game to where my belly doesn't hold that much. So we'll see. we'll see. I will keep you guys posted and we'll go from there. And I also take a picture and show you guys exactly what it is that I am eating. So you can just get an idea. But other than that, that's what the bulk of my day is going to be like, okay? So I'm on my way to work and I will hit you guys up probably at lunchtime so that you guys can see. But so far, I hope you have a good day. It's a pretty day here. Smile, remember to love yourself and stay blessed. I'll get back with you in just a little bit. All right, y'all. See ya.